Martin McGuinness was never in any doubt about what he wanted: an end to British rule in Northern Ireland.
I'm an Irish Republican. In an Irish context, a Republican is someone who believes that the British government should have no part to play in the life of this island, that we believe this island should be free.
McGuinness was born into poverty in the bogside slums of Londonderry, a city that would become the cradle of the Republican movement in the province. In the late 1960s, Londonderry's Catholics took to the streets demanding civil rights, an end to Protestant dominance of Northern Ireland. McGuinness joined the IRA, the Irish Republican Army, to fight.
The first time I picked up a stone was during the Battle of the Bogside, which was in 1969, whenever the town effectively erupted.
By 1972 and Bloody Sunday, when British paratroopers fired on angry demonstrators, killing 13 unarmed civilians, McGuinness had risen to be an IRA commander. In the early 80s, McGuinness became an elected politician for Sinn Fein, the political wing of the IRA. But even as the IRA launched bombing attacks in Northern Ireland and mainland Britain, McGuinness was talking with British officials, a risky initiative.
We were dealing with very devious people who had the capability, if they so wished, effectively to destroy me as a Republican and effectively bring about a set of circumstances where I could lose my life as a result of my participation in these talks.
His risk eventually paid off. The 1998 Good Friday Peace Agreement called for power sharing between Catholic and Protestants. Vindication came at the ballot box. Sinn Féin's popularity soared, the most powerful Catholic party in Northern Ireland. In a new power sharing government, McGuinness rose to be Deputy First Minister, the first in his party to shake hands with Britain's Queen Elizabeth, a testament to how far this one-time Republican terrorist had come. But after 10 years of power sharing with Protestants, McGuinness abruptly resigned.
So I believe today is the right time to call a halt to the DUP's arrogance.
It was all the more shocking because he appeared so visibly weak. He was ill. It was the last roll of the political dice, a Republican through and through.
Well, I've always believed in myself. From the day that I stood with the young people and the old people of Derry and threw stones during the Battle of the Bogside, it was from that moment on that I believed in myself, that I believed that we could achieve important things.
A belief he never let go.